Twitch Gamer.
Good morning, YouTube peep. Marvin here, back on European Truck Simulator 2. Gone back and I've put my Scania. This is one of the first trucks that I owned on European Truck Simulator 2. I've put the John Ruder truck away. I love my John Ruder trucks, don't get me wrong. But we've gone back to this one. And we have signed up on this, I believe. We've signed up for the World of Trucks. So, without further ado, let's jump in, guys, shall we? I think we've just taken a job on World of Trucks, and I believe it's a digger blade, a bulldozer blade, sorry. And I think it's night time. So how is everybody doing? Happy Monday to everybody. I can't believe Monday's come around so quick. Holy doodles noodles. Got a new webcam set up. I haven't got the overhead. I've got it to my left. So here we go. In gear, Marvin. And let's get the truck out of here.
Turn right.
Mile an hour here.
Go around the roundabout. Second exit. Take the exit.
What's this one? What is this one?
Keep left. Then turn left. Turn left. Turn right.
Gotta make sure, because we got a big trailer.
You have reached your destination.
Oh, we're going in there. Of course we are. Let's see where my buttons work. Do they not work? Oh, yes, they do. Aha! My old buttons work. Hate nighttime driving, I do. Can't see bugger all behind me. Going the wrong way, Marvin. Let me do that again, and we're going the wrong way. It's night time. I'm okay at reversing. It's just bloody night time reversing that I just can't do it. Here we go. We're in there. We're in there. Good morning, Dave. How are you doing, buddy? Come on, lay off, lay off, lay off. Here we go. Lay off a bit more, a bit more. How you doing? Yeah, I'm doing not too badly. I've put me John Ruder truck away, and we're back on the Scania, which I had quite some time ago. Will you please load it? Thank you. Back on my old Scania. Really nice truck, this Scania. Let me turn my beacons off. I suppose we could do the beacons. Someone's just increased. John! John M has just increased. Nice one, buddy. I had a little bit of a problem. Let me turn the engine off so I'm not shouting over. I had a little bit of a problem with World of Trucks. I thought I was logged in all the time I've been playing the game from way back when. And they're not been counting for some reason. Plus, you know, I did do the number plates. My number plate's working now. So I don't know what I did. I think I logged on and I logged off again. And I think it's now World of Trucks are seeing me. So all those jobs that I bloody well did didn't count. So, it shit happens. Oh, lovely brew. Lovely brew. Come on, Kathy, where are we going, love? I think we're going that
turn
way.
Turn left.
Yeah, let me get me. Got a car coming because I really want to swing out. We've got a car coming that way. I think if we don't go now, we never will. There we go, we're out. Yeah, so the John Ruder truck has been put away. I will go back to it. It's a really beautiful truck. And John Ruder has brought out some other trucks, which I'm keeping my eye on. Plus, he's got some really nice trailers as well on a trailer pack. So I'm keeping my eye on that as well.
Left turn ahead. Turn left.
Got to overemphasize because we've got such a long load. I think it's 42 or 52 feet long. So it's a heavy hauler. We're going to be doing a earth digger or blade. And I think we're going away on the continent. Hang on a minute, whoa, hang on a minute, where are we? Right, okay. Yeah, we're going over. Let's go over here because we're going to leave Dover and we're going across. Slow to roll. Yeah, do we go up that one or that one? We're not going down, are we? No, we're going over there. I think the big barrier gives it away, Marvin. In the right place. I don't see no I don't think we're in the right place, guys. Where the heck is it then? It's definitely here, but I don't see no... Huh? Where is it then? Where's normally a green marker up here, but then... Are we on the right boat? Oh, we are on the right boat. I just didn't see the marker. Yeah, let's embark. It's probably because of those lights. I've got the halogen. I've got the halogen mods on. This is my account with my mods on. I think I've got yellow lines, and I've got other stuff as well. Not using my head tracker this morning. We are on the opposite side of the road now, Marvin, so we've got to be careful. This is a bit of a loop-de-doop-de, isn't it? I suppose they're keeping us away from... they're keeping us away from the main drivers because we're heavy. The trucks off before the cars, or was it the cars before the trucks? I can't remember. Not been abroad for a long time. I think after being playing American Truck, it's nice going back to European Truck. I still think the roads feel narrower to me. I don't know why. I'm in right dead bald centre, but I still feel like I'm enclosed. Well, we are speeding as well. I do like these lights on this rig. I really do. Don't get me wrong, American Truck's really, really good. Both of my American Truck and my European Truck, I've got it on ultra settings. But I don't know, European Truck have just got that edge on the scenery for me. Just got that slight edge. Why have I got my hazards on?
Keep right, then take the exit right.
I was just about to say, Gaffy's not speaking to me.
Take the exit right.
Send me to Coventry. I still haven't fired up, Dave. I still haven't fired up Shipyard Graveyard 2. I still haven't had a look at that yet. I will get around to it. I've been having loads of other stuff as well. Are you going to let me out? Thank you. got two accounts on both American Truck and European Truck. I've got this one, which is the modded, and then I've got another one on European Truck, which is unmodded. So all of my mods, there's no mods, it's just pure. And I've got exactly the same for American Truck as well. Oh, apart from the satellite, which is the one above. Apart from that, on the American Truck, I do like heads-up
display.
Keep
left.
And I am thinking, my next contract car, I'm going to get heads-up display. Is it me, or have those cars don't look like they've got any bloody lights on? The heck is going on? Are we turning here? She didn't say.
Take the exit left.
I was speaking, which I probably was. Getting round to my brew as well. I don't want that getting cold. Epic made it for me before the stream. Hi, how are you doing, Lion? How's things with you, buddy? My horn doesn't work. How are you, buddy? Let me just... Not following Lion, guys, do drop them a follow. Last playing Dead Space. I tell you what, Lion plays some really jump scares. He really does play a lot of jump scares. Oh, God. You're doing well? Yeah, I'm not doing too badly, actually. A little bit of a better day with my irritable bowel. I know, TMI. But yeah, it's not too bad, not too bad. Thank you for asking. So yeah, Lion, if you're not following him, it really does. Plays games because he wants to, you know, a bit like me. I play games, I don't stream for monetary or gain, and stuff like that. Yeah, that one that you were playing, oh man, I tell you, that one was really, really scary. I was pissing my pants, I was. Not Dead Space, the other one. And I can't remember what it was called. But bloody hell, Del, I tell you. My God. The Evil in Me. Is that what it was called? Can't remember. I've slept since then. Oh my God. It really was. Now, I've got a few fellow streamers that do play that game where you've got to get the Phantom and what have you. You do loads and loads. I can't remember what it's called. Phantoma? I can't remember what it's bloody called. And you basically solve puzzles. That is a jump scare as well. I know Mr. G plays it as well. But yeah, I mean, I like solving clues. I do like puzzles, but sometimes these puzzles can really get you down. especially when you go, bloody hell, what have I got to freaking well do here? Let me get over here. Kathy is going to tell me to keep right anyway. So we're hauling right from Dover, and we've got a rock bucket, I suppose. It's one of those rock earth mover type of things. And we're taking it somewhere. We're abroad at the moment. I think we're taking it to SPNTP. I think it's in Stuttgart. Is it Stuttgart? Oh, Hanover. We're taking it to Hanover. There you go. I thought it was Stuttgart. Why did I think it was Stuttgart? I don't know. It's Monday. I'm blaming it on Monday. So let me show you what we're hauling. Whoa. Easy, Tiger. I'm warming up the tyres. We're all in that bad boy. This is a new trailer as well. So I really don't want to be denting my trailer. What I am going to do is I'm going to pause it momentarily. And I'm going to have my brew. I'm going to polish my brew off because it's going to get stone cold. And I hate cold tea. Oh, I'm dribbling. There we go. That's out of the way. Yeah, so I don't know what's happened to my World of Trucks. I signed up for World of Trucks way back
left.
2014, 2015. And I really don't know what's going on. All that time that I was doing all the trucking that I did. Now, I'm level 57. I've got a rating of 10. And it's not counted. Not that it really matters. I really like doing the events when they have different events on American Truck and European Truck. So what we could do... Now, we still need our light... Now, we better leave our lights on. We better, otherwise we're going to get a bloody fine. I don't know why. I do not know why my lights didn't work when I first started to play this. Because I cranked this up yesterday. Because I have a feeling over the weekend what I want to stream for the next week. Normally it's not a closely guarded secret, but I like keeping you on your toes. I have got a schedule, but it's not a fixed schedule. Do check it out below. Monday, Wednesday and Friday in the mornings from 11 till 1, and then BST/GMT, and then in the evening 7 p.m. till 9 p.m. UK time. And then Tuesdays and Thursdays, I have off. I do stream sometimes. If I'm home alone and Epic is going to a craft fair, I do stream at the weekend if she is crafting. I do like these yellow lines. I don't know if anyone's got these activated. Yellow lines are really, really cool. Over in the UK, we got double yellow lines and single yellow lines. Single yellow lines mean that you can only park for 5 minutes, and double yellow lines means you're not allowed to park unless you're handicapped or unless you've broken down. But yeah, I do like these. I do like the yellow lines.
Keep right, then take the exit right.
New webcam to my left. I've got it on a tripod.
Take the exit right.
Okay, Kathy. And it's on top of my AC unit. I thought, well, might as well use my AC unit as well. So it's on top of there on a extra, what am I going to say, extra tall. It's around about 20 inches tall. Alexa, what's 20 inches tall in centimetres?
Something I found on the internet.
I don't know.
20 inches is equal to 50.8 centimetres.
Yes, thank you, darling.
You're welcome, sweetie.
Yeah, I'm a feet and inches man. I mean, you know, you can't break an habit of a lifetime, and I'm very bad at metric and stuff like that. I suppose if you brought up with it, then it would be second nature, but I'm just not that. It's quite weird actually, because we've just recently had louver blinds fitted. We did have vertical blinds, and I don't know, I rung up a few companies, and is it? Yeah. And I said to them, you know, it's approximately 5'6" by, I don't know, 72 drop. And they went, hang on a minute, let me convert that. Let me just pull over a bit. Oh, did I set yours off too? Sorry. I'm always doing that with Bo. Son of a biscuit. I always do that with Bo. I normally say, ask your Alexandra what the conversion is from dollars to pounds, or from pounds
keep
to dollars.
Keep left, then go straight on.
You know, I'm that. Oh man, I'm in the wrong lane. Son of a biscuit. Can I get over? Will you let me
go
over?
Go straight on.
Are you going to let me over? You're going to let me over, thank you. The AI in this game can be right douchebags. They can. And sometimes the actual trucks, in American truck and European truck, are really, really courteous. See, now, you got traffic emerging from the right. Now, in the UK, when we have traffic merging from the left, because we drive on the right side of the road. I know you drive on the right side of the road, but we drive on the left, and we have traffic emerging from the right where you have it opposite. And so basically you've got to, if you can, get out into that middle lane, yeah, and let them come on, because it's courteous to do that. But some of the rules in the continent and in America are completely different to what they are over here. They really are. This is a rock mover that I'm hauling. I would say it's an earth mover, me. And it, you know, what do I know? Evidently, that's a rock thingy. I suppose it looks like it could be, because if you've seen all that on there, holy biscuit crumbs, look at the blinking, look at the things on that. I think it's curved as well. That is one bit of machinery. It is a bit of machinery. Let me just pull over, because I really would like to take a picture of this. Let me make sure that I'm on there. Let me put my hazards on. Let me go into there. Can I go into photographic mode? Oh, I can. Look at that. I can go into photographic mode. That's cool. Oh, that's a bit of a bad one, isn't it? Look. Let me go up a bit and let me come down. So there you go. That is what we're hauling. Am I clear of that? Is my bum sticking out? I've got a fluffy butt and I cannot lie. Hello, sir. Hello, madam.
Sorry,
I'm not sure about that.
Okay, okay. Alexa, what did I say?
I heard. Hello, madam.
Why does she always chirp up? There's my personalised number plate as well, which I think is really cool. And this is my truck here. I really do love my truck. This was done by somebody for me. I have actually duplicated this onto a man truck. And I think I did it on a... I did it for Dave as well. I actually thought, do you know what? I can do that. And I did. Right, let's take a picture of that. Let me come down. I'm getting in the right spot. And then I'm going to back up. I want to get my truck in there as well. So there you go. That will go on my Steam. And we can go back driving then, can't we? Yeah, we can go back driving. Are they going to let me out?
Sugar Wugger is in the house.
Sugar Wugger!
Pixelated.
I ain't gonna let me out. Thank you, sir. How are you doing, Sugar Wugger? Let me turn my assets off. How are you doing?
Keep left, then go straight on.
This is a rock mover.
Go straight on.
We're in the wrong lane again. We're in the wrong lane again. I'm always in the wrong lane. It's quite weird going from American truck to European truck again. Wrong lane, yeah, I know, wrong lane. I had to do my seat adjustment and everything because I'm only 5'8". So I had to put my seat properly. I had to get my side windows all done and all the rest of it. So yes, it's... And I've got a new thingy over here. I'm pointing so you can...
Keep left, then go straight on.
Well, we've got to keep left. Let's keep left. Let's keep our mind on the job.
Go straight on.
So, yeah, I actually did one for Dave. And did I do it for the man, Dave? I think I did. And it's got his name on it in fire and everything. And I put a... it was either for the man or it was for this... It was for the Mercedes. I can't remember. I can't remember. I've slept since then. I have. I don't know why my horn won't work.
Mm-mm.
I can do my own horn. Oh, are you switching to European truck today? Ah, you see, great minds think alike. There you go. It's quite weird coming back to European truck, so do expect paint rubs.
Go straight on.
Oh, no, I'm in the wrong lane again. Hang on, what we do? We're going to do a rollie. I've got a friend of mine called Donny Theory, and he's a nutter. I am not kidding you. He is as mad as a box of frogs, and he does rollies. And this is a rollie. And anyway, that one was planned. It was. Believe that, you believe anything. What's my fuel? My fuel is all right. I have got a little bit of wear, but that's okay. That is okay. What? How come that went up late? This is European Truck Simulator Tour. Do you know what? I never played European Truck. Was there a European Truck? So this is European Truck Simulator 2, but I never did play. Has anyone played European? Dave has probably played it. Dave has probably played European Truck Simulator. I don't know, I'm going to have to Google it. I'm going to be puzzled now. I get puzzled all the time, me, I tell you. Right, let's keep me mind on the job. Let's keep your mind on the job, Barmy.
Keep left.
I thought Kathy had sent me to Coventry because she weren't talking to me when we got on the boat. She didn't even tell me where to go. I'm going to have to find out why my horn is not working. See, that's the normal one. But I normally got one for this button here. If you can see on the extra webcam. This button here is the Xbox key. And they'll normally go... Oh, speed in! Son of a biscuit. Right, how far we got to go? 193 miles. We've got 4 hours, and I've got 8 hours. That's okay. We got plenty. I don't need to sleep yet. It's fine. Do you know what? I haven't got in this cab. I haven't got Fred. Fred's not on the back seat. Never ever thought of playing this manual. I like automatic, mate. I have got a gear shifter down here, but I've never ever wanted to. I mean, I'd have to have a converter because this is a 6-speed shift, and some of them are 18 speed, aren't they? 18 speed, 8 speed. So you'd have to have a button on the side of it to click over to do that. You played a racing game called Grand, yeah. Oh, I have got, and I picked up, and I still haven't played it, and I picked it up for cheap as chips. I think it was something like, £4.53, and I think it was what was it, Isle of Man TT 3 or 2, was it? I can't remember. And I haven't played that one yet neither. I do like my bikes. Back in my ute, I had a Yamaha 350LC, and that was my absolutely my love of my life. It really was. Had it Stan Stephen tuned. There's a company in London called Stan Stephen. I took the engine out of it and I put it on a small little pallet. And then they put it in on a train to London, and they chromed the exhaust ports, they honed out the pistons, oversized pistons, they done the crank on it and all the rest of it, and it was a flying machine. I am speeding. And then I think I got to where I was working for a company where I was, I wanted to be a machine setter, and I was a machine operator, and I just couldn't put up with putting all the gear on in the morning, getting to work, taking all the gear off, putting it in my side pods, And I thought, you know what? I'm done with this, really. I really need a car. And I decided to get myself a car. My first car was a Renault 6 TL, and I've still got my Dinkler going. And I put a 1600 TX in it. Had to send it to Swansea to have it verified that it was all above board.
Keep right.
And I had the logbook changed.
Take the exit right.
And that was my. After that, you know, you just put your.
Take the exit right.
A light jacket in, and then you just jump in the car, and you ain't got to worry about your lid on, putting your levers on, and all the rest of it. But I still see bikes, and I still love bikes, Triumphs, and all the rest of it. I went to Alexandra Palace in London, and there was a fair there. And there was a fair there, and I saw a Kawasaki 900R, and oh my God, Kawasaki 900R. And the guy who owned it, I said to him, you know, can I sit on it? And he went, yeah, sure, mate. He said, but can you take your jacket off? Because there was like little hoppers on my jacket, and he didn't want the tank scratched. So I said, yeah, sure, mate. So I just folded up my jacket, put it on the floor, and got on the bike. Oh man, that bike. And he said, you can start it up if you like. And I started up, electric start. I was a person where you kick-started it, yeah? This was electric start. You just went, turn the ignition on, make sure it's in neutral. There you go. Oh, that was a beautiful, beautiful bike.
Keep right, then take the exit right.
And boys and toys. Right. Boys and toys.
Turn right.
Oh, let me turn my signal off. I'm not hearing the signal because the engine on this Scania, I wouldn't say it's loud, it's the turbo on it is really loud. I could turn down the settings, but you guys wouldn't appreciate it. So how far we got to go? 91 miles, that's okay. We've got 91 to go. I just can't believe Monday has come around so quick. I just can't believe it. Is it fine for you? Yeah, please tell me. If anyone wants me to turn it down a bit, I will turn it down. See, when I've got the engine sound up and cranked it up a bit, I don't like it too loud for me, because I can turn down my wireless headset and it doesn't sound a lot to me, you see. And then if I've got it too loud, what I normally do is I normally raise my voice, because I think I'm shouting and you can't hear me, but you can. And Epic gets annoyed with me, which he goes, you're too loud, I can hear you over the TV. It's gonna be a hot one this week, guys, in the UK. Expecting to get to about, I mean, I know it's not hot for other people, especially how and other people in different parts of the world. It's going to get up to about 27, 28 degrees. I mean, how's got temperatures of 98, and then the humidity on top of that. And he said to me, he went out to let his dog out because he's got a rescue dog called Coco. And he said he went out and went out onto the porch and into the back garden to let him out. He said, and I opened the door and it was like walking out into a brick wall. He said the humidity was so hot. Well, that's what it's like in Alabama. Frigging high temperatures. Epic couldn't cope in that temperature. Oh, and I'm speeding again. Ah, man. Really? I'm used to American truck where I can go at 70. But this is not that. I mean, I could put my cruise control on. It's a wonder I haven't got a speed ticket, actually. I haven't. Has anyone seen a police bell? Or policia? I haven't seen them about. I'm looking. Mind you, they're about when you don't want them, and then when you want them, then nobody would be to be found. Still can't see one. Oh, and I'm speeding again. Right, let me get Cruisy on. There we go, I've got cruise control on. I got a lead foot and I can't help it. I should take
my
I should take my shoe off. That'd be a lot better, wouldn't it? Taking my shoe off. Trouble is, this is the only trouble with cruise control. You get yourself set with cruise control, and there's around about three factors that go on. Okay, you'll get a dipshit person in front of you that will decide to go slow, and then you'll get roadworks, or then the speed of the road will change. See, look, my retarder's not working. Why is my retarder not working? That should be a set speed, that. What the frig is going on? There we go. My retarder's not working. I have got a retarder, but it's not working. It went to 54, and I put the cruise control at 50. It's fluctuating at 50, 51. I don't get that. Yes, probably. Probably.
Keep right. Then take the exit right.
Okay, Kathy.
Take the exit right.
Right, let me slow down.
Turn right.
We're not doing too badly on fuel, actually. Mind you, this is a 300 gallon, or is it a 320 capacity? Yes, when you come back to European Truck Chooks, are you streaming it today? When you finish work? Be prepared for narrow lanes and narrow streets. It's all I'm going to say. I nearly hit a guardrail coming out from the...
Keep left.
Coming out.
Then turn left.
From my garage. And then I nearly went into a car as well.
Turn left.
See, this lane's not too bad. It's when you come off a slip road, off of a motorway down a slip road is where it gets really, really narrow. And I'm thinking, I'm a freaking truckie. How am I supposed to get down here?
Keep left. Then turn left. Turn left.
But then again, you see, the trucks in European truck are not really as wide as what they are in American truck. So they're But I see a lot of people when they're driving in real life, they don't know the width of their truck and they do it for their car. And they turn right to turn left and turn left to turn right, and it really just chapped my nipples.
Keep right.
I'm thinking, dude, you've not got a trailer on there, so why are you turning left to turn right? I don't get it.
Keep right, then turn right. Turn right.
I just braked there, and it's completely stopped me. Well, I've got a big end and I cannot lie. Oh no, TMI.
Left turn ahead.
I can't remember whether this trailer's got steering on it.
Turn left.
Assisted steering, sorry. Not steering, duh. We'll find out. I find that trailers that have got assisted steering, the actual wheels on the back end move that way, and you think you've got it bob on, and you haven't. You're out by about 2 foot, 4 foot. How far have we got to go then? 4 miles. It's a long bloody 4 miles, isn't it? FCP.
Right turn ahead.
FCP.
Turn right.
I like traffic lights like this. This is what I love. An American truck, they're way up in the air and you can't see them. So I stay back in American trucks so I can see that light. But that is brilliant. That is brilliant. France has got good lights as well. They've got lights there for both truck drivers and for normal cars.
Keep left, then turn left.
I'm just looking
turn
at my,
left.
At my fluffy butt. Jesus, left, right, up, down, sideways. Holy crap doodles. Where are we going? We're on a road to nowhere. Come on inside. We've only
right
gone,
turn ahead.
We've only gone 1 mile. Tell you what, these brakes are absolutely on the nail. They really are.
Turn right.
Right, now I've got to go left to turn right to compensate my trailer behind me. But when you're a car and you do that, or did I just clip that curb? Or did? Is it because we need to be getting there because we're going to be late? Oh no, we're going to have a late. But I see cars do it and I'm thinking, are you stupid? Now, we weren't hanging
right
about.
Right turn ahead.
In some places we were speeding, so how? Right, okay.
Turn right.
Oh, so we're going around the freaking houses here. Oh. You've got to worry about the cars that are on the other side of the road. You've got to worry about your trailer. And then narrow roads. Wow. We're going all the way up there to come all the way back. Are you joking me?
Keep left, then turn left.
I suppose if you want...
Turn left.
Okay. If you want straight roads, go to Rome. Hello? Where do you want it? Oh, I'm not even there yet. What? Oh, of course. This looks like it's over. This is where they break up massive, great big stones, isn't it? And make them into three quarter down or quarter down. In layman's terms, road planings and stuff like that, gravel. And they break all these rocks down. Look at all that stuff there. I nearly swore. Look at that stuff there. Got a JCB there. They could clean it up and put it in a skip. Whoa. Oh, it's all shake, rattle and roll. I've got to find my way out of here yet. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, Jesus. My steering wheel's vibrating like no one's business. Yeah, whoa, slow down, mommy. Now we've got to go over here to go around that corner. Are we going to make it? Yeah, we can do this. We can do it. Jesus, this is right around the mountains, isn't it? Here be coming round the mountain where we come. Have we got a photographic moment over it? Oh, we have. We could do a photograph. Ow. Hang on, like, turn me engine off. Here we go, guys. This is what could be a quarry pit. And we got to go over there. We got to go over there and then probably down that freaking slope. Wow. That is cool. So this is what they need that rock bucket for. Oh, yeah, baby. That is well cool. Right, I'm going to bring YouTube to an end. Thank you, YouTube peeps. Like and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Remember to hit that bell.
Remember to like and subscribe. And please hit that